फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू LBW। दिस इज गणेश। प्लीज यूज द आई बटन टू वॉच माई प्रीवियस वीडियोज। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी स्पार्क शार्ड वेरिएबल्स। स्पार्क प्रोवाइड्स टू वेरिएबल्स, दे आर ब्रॉडकास्ट वेरिएबल एंड अकुमुलेटर्स। फर्स्ट वी विल सी अबाउट ब्रॉडकास्ट वेरिएबल्स। It allows the programmer to keep a read-only variable cached on each machine rather than shipping a copy of it with the task. They can be used to give every node a copy of large input data set in an efficient manner. Spark attempts to distribute broadcast variable using efficient broadcasting algorithm to reduce communication cost. Spark actions are executed through a set of stages separated by distributed shuffle operations. By default, Spark automatically broadcasts the common data needed by the task within each stage, where the data is cached in serialized form and deserialized before running each task. We need to create broadcast variables when task across multiple stages need the same data, or when caching the data is in deserialized form is important. Broadcast variables are created by calling spark context dot broadcast with the value, and the value can be accessed by using the value method. After broadcasting the variable, we should not change the value, or we should not pass the value to the function, so that we will avoid shipping data more than once to the node, or we will keep the same value in all the nodes. To release the resources that the broadcast variable occupied in the executors, we need to call unpersist. To permanently release all the resources, we need to call destroy method. Here we have created a broadcast variable using the spark context dot broadcast to fetch the value of the broadcast variable. We use the method value, then we call unpersist method to release the resource occupied by the broadcast variable. To permanently release the resources occupied by broadcast variable, we call the destroy method. The next one is accumulators. Accumulators are variables that are only added to through an associative and commutative operation, and therefore be efficiently supported in parallel. They are used to implement counters or sums. Spark natively supports accumulators of numeric types, where programmers can add support for new types. We could create a named or unnamed accumulators. Spark displays the value for each accumulator modified by a task in tasks table, which is available in Spark web UI. Accumulators are created by calling spark context dot accumulator with the required value. Task running on cluster can then add it using the add method or plus equal to operator. However, they cannot read its value. Only the driver program can read the accumulator's value using value method. Accumulators do not change the lazy evaluation model of Spark. They are being updated with an operation on an RDD. Their values is only updated once the RDD is computed as part of an action. Here we have created accumulated variable using the Spark context dot accumulator with the value 0. We could see the value is 0 here for the accumulated variable. Then we are calling the dot add function with the accumulated variable to add each value in the data set to the accumulated value 0. So when we check the value of accumulator after execution, we could find the value as 10. Here we are creating one more accumulator variable with 0 as value. Then we have created a function which is adding accumulator value with the data. The data is getting created here, and we are calling the map function on the data, and we are passing the function inside the map. After the execution, we are checking the accumulator value. We could find only 0 because of the lazy evaluation model of Spark. Here we don't perform any action, so we did not get the value. After applying the action on the variable, we are getting the value here. That's all for the video. Please share the channel and subscribe the channel. Thank you. Have a good day.